Hi, it has been a while ago, but today we are finally having a new video, and it's about this model from Danny Sanchez. So let's get started. Some time ago I found this lamp by Danny Sanchez. It's called the Christmas Village lamp, and it's a really nice model. So let's have a look at it. Let's turn on the light because I did add some hardware in it and have a discussion how it looks. So before we go into it, let's discuss first what these two blocks are. The single color models, which are the bridges over here at the front, which is printed in Colorfab's food fill, which is a really nice filament. And for example, the eyes here on front and the base at the back are printed on my new original Prusa MK3S. The multicolor models, which are the houses here in the back and the small Christmas tree in front, are printed on my original Prusa MK2, and I use the Pallet 2 Pro for that. And that just is a perch block, and yes, that is a large perch block. But in my personal opinion, I don't really mind. The model came out fantastic, and that's worth around 350 grams of filament. Yes, it is a bit of a waste of filament. Yes, it is a lot of filament, but personally, I don't matter. So I know it is a lot, but there's no need to post it in the comments. Okay, now let's have a look at the model itself and put those away. So the model itself is built out of multiple parts. So we have first the bridges itself here at the front. Then we have, it is sort of ice, but you can also print it in blue and then it is water. That's just one part. And then we have here the rotating part. That's one print. That rotating part took around 3 hours to print. The bridge and the water in total, I think around 2 hours. The base itself, which is here up front, took also around 2 hours. And the houses, which is the most complex part, and also the most really nice looking part, took around 26 hours on. And I did slow it down a tiny bit because my Pallet 2 had a bit of problems with keeping it up. But in general, it printed really well. So what I did is I added a few LED strips. So it is inside here, and if I remove this very carefully, you can see here there are some light strips here. What I did is I was just grabbing a bit of electronics I had laying around. So I didn't have a real list of things I bought. I actually had all of it here laying around. So this is not the most optimal hardware I have here. So please keep that in mind. So what I did use was a Wemos D1 Mini, which Platform IO as code. And I then have a LED strip with 8 LEDs on there, so which is perfect. And because I want to be able to control it from distance, so I don't want to have it just be, I need to go there and change it. I just want to have controllable. I added a small feature to change it from the from Wi-Fi. I will put all code online and you can use it. And it's basically really easy written. There is some configurations option in there and you can just use it for anything. Personally, I just use it for this, but it can be used for anything else as well. So that's great. Let's turn on the lights and I will show you how this actually looks like. I won't be able to show it on camera, but it is a real small website with a few buttons. And basically when I press the green button, it will go to green. And it can also go to red, yellow and orange. So yes, that's basically it. Do you want to print this as well? I will post a link to the model within the video description. It is a really nice model and I think it's around $9. So it's not that expensive and you will be able to get it from my mini factory. And before we end this video, I would like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you for watching and hopefully see you next time. Bye for now.